Hello kids, today we are going to start a new lesson, that is the model of the earth. So in this module we are going to learn the shape of the earth, the globe, north pole, south pole, the northern hemisphere and the southern hemisphere. So the shape of the earth. Long ago everyone believed that the earth was flat like a coin. Can you see in the picture? Yes. But later on, when pictures were taken from the space, then we got to know that Earth is actually spherical like a sphere. Yes, can you see in this picture? Yes. To make the study of this huge spherical Earth easy and on a smaller scale, geographer discovered a globoid map. So, let's see what is a globe. So, globe is a small model of Earth that shows the correct shape and location of the continent, ocean and seas on the smaller scale. So it shows the correct shape and location of the continent and oceans. The globe, we can only see the half of the globe at one time. However, we have to turn the globe around to see the other half. So, the globe can be turned around. A line passes through it. This line is called an axis. Can you see the line? So, this is an axis. It is tilted at an angle of 23 and of degree. The two end points of the axis of rotations are called poles. Can you see that poles? Is to the north, it is north pole, and to the south, it is south pole. Let's see what is equator. The midway between the poles is an imaginary line circling the earth, is an equator. Can you see the red line? This is called a equator. Let's see hemispheres. This equator divides the earth into two equal halves, that is called hemisphere. To the north, it is a northern hemisphere, and to the south, it is a southern hemisphere.
Latitudes and longitudes will be explained in another class. Now let us do the exercise activities. So, first main is fill in the blanks. This one you should do only in your content book. You should write in your pencil. So, the first one is, the earth rotates along an imaginary line is called axis. Second one, the earth is divided into two hemispheres along an imaginary line called the equator. So, second main is, answer the following question. This one you should write in your notes. You should write in new page. You should use your black pen to write the question and blue pen to write the answer. So the first question is, how is the globe is useful? The globe shows us the exact shape and location of continents, ocean, seas, countries and some important cities. I hope all have understood the chapter. Go through your chapter once. Thank you. Stay home and stay safe.